Hi, my name is Miss Moonshine, and as I've said in the past, I am going to be promoting good posture, not only for musicians, but for everyone.
So currently we're facing an epidemic of poor posture in the world.
When I went to the physical therapist yesterday at the University Hospital, I said, what percent of your patients here do you think are here because of bad posture? There was a pause, and then she said, you know what, 100% of our patients need to be worried about posture. Everyone needs to be worried about their posture. We have an epidemic of people in a curved over hunchback position because they are looking at the computer or sitting or looking at their phone. It's almost impossible for me to sit and maintain good posture like I have right now. That's because most of us do not have the core support. The reason that bad posture creates muscle tension is because the certain muscles, which let me just define up front, the upper trapezius and their levator scapularis, which allow your head to make this kind of motion, have to work double time in order to keep your head up when it's forward looking down. So if you kept your head up, and for example, if you looked at your phone like this, then your muscles don't need to work so hard to pull your head up. So your head weighs between about 10 and 12 pounds. And when you have it forward, the lower it's tilted forward, the more pounds, so now the weight is actually like to the muscles, it's increased by gravity. It's a lot of work for your neck to have to hold this back. Let's just review what is good posture. So good posture is the tip of your ear is over the tip of your shoulder. So, but also you want your shoulder blades rolled down the back and flat so that they're not curved over here. The chest should be open and not, you know, a lot of times when people open the chest, they immediately lock their knees and then their butt is jutted out. So you wanna actually open your chest but keep a light bend in your knees, which actually helps. Now, for all you ladies out there, we were always raised to be sort of shy about our mammary glands. So there was just a lot of encouragement to kind of cover them up. It was considered feminine growing up to kind of, you know, hide your boobs. But as a result, for decades of doing that, then most women have incredibly rounded shoulders. So how do we go about improving posture when we are older people? We become aware of what is good in past posture. This is something that takes a mindset. You need to understand and kind of make it part of your waking hour and your routine to reverse the closure of the chest. And it is very hard, but basically what we do is, because we've been like this at our computers for like 8 hours a day and then watching TV like that, because most of our days, and then we're sleeping like that, so because most of our day is in this closed forward position, we need to really make as much effort as possible to open the chest back up. Over time, you want this, there's the pectoralis muscles, major and minor, and the back of the armpit. There's a muscle called subscapular from the back under the scapula, under the shoulder blade to the front. These things are very tight and very contracted along with our psoas muscles, the hip flexor, because we're sitting all the time. That's also really tight and those are all pulling forward. Yeah, we need to open up the psoas too. We need to also strengthen all these muscles which are weak. Now when you go to the back of most 50-year-olds, there's like no muscle anymore. It's all, well, the only muscle there is the one that's overcompensating for our bad posture, the upper traps there. But beyond that, it's mostly just, you know, sinew and bone. So we need to develop these muscles between the traps by pinching the scaps together, keeping, not engaging the upper trap, but keeping the middle and lower trap engaged up, getting used to keeping our knees bent, strengthening the core, and also strengthening the ability of the thorax the spine, the upper spine needs mobility. And there's a lot of things we can do to help get that mobility in the upper spine, because that mobility helps us to keep that open posture. And then, of course, the chin tuck, so important. We're going to go over that, how you keep your chin tucked in so that you have that strong posterior column, back of the neck muscles are strong. You're able to naturally, like when you're practicing music, you get motor memory. You're creating by daily chin tucks and scap pinches. You're creating the motor memory for you to know, like when you're eating, you're like, oh my God. Your muscles like, why? I don't need to be that hunched to eat. You know, let me straighten it up. So you want to create that motor memory. And of course, like with music, you got to keep it up or your memory is lost. Same with the posture. So you got to keep it up. You incorporate this into your routine, your daily life. Like, look for hacks. What you can do to, say, hold your phone at eye level, or... you know, what you can you do to adjust your laptop, adjust your driving position, adjust your cooking position to keep yourself. Oh, here's a great, I naturally fall into this one because this is one of my favorite stretches. It opens the chest, externally rotates it open. And I'm also doing a chin tuck into the hand as well. So I'm pushing the hands forward. I'm developing the muscles in the back. And then I'm also, pinching them together. It's like a really great habit. You get habits that help you create openness and strength in the back. That's the solution. And it's something you have to make into your daily routine, that you want to do it naturally. So to review, good posture is your chin is tucked in, your tips of your ear are over the tips of your shoulder, which themselves, your chest is out, and your rear is tucked by slightly bending your knees. Like, just think about that. Remember when you ever had a tennis lesson, they were like, bend your knees. Cause that like keeps you more stable and ready to move in any direction. Try to adopt a healthy stance. And one way to keep that stance, like when you're in line somewhere, to kind of keep your fingertips together, that helps create this, your shoulder blade have the, ability to stay flat in the back. So when you drop the arms, there is a tendency to immediately roll over. So this helps you kind of support. And then at the same time, you could be doing little scap pinches to stand tall. Let's just quickly talk about your thumbs. So when you're in a poor posture, because of that rounded shoulder, your thumbs are pointed together. And so one way to kind of know whether your shoulders are rounded, because it's hard to know what they're doing. So when you open your chest, notice there is a tendency, you know, there's a natural, your thumbs should go forward. Now I'm so rounded, they really don't actually go forward pointing anymore. They're always still pointed because I'm so rounded from decades of rounded shoulders. But one healthy way to do it is to kind of keep your fingertips together. And then practice little pinches throughout the day. And then if you have to hang your arms, try to keep your thumbs pointed forward or just even out to keep that open chest, external rotation of the chest. Now, you may ask yourself, I'm almost 60, is it even worth it? Well, so good posture helps us reduce the unavoidable, which is degeneration of the spine. But it allows us to have a chance to slow down that degeneration and create more space for the nerves as they leave the spine. Achieving good posture over time it's a process and it's a mindset. You have to make it part of your mindset pretty much as soon as you wake up, and even when you wake up in the night, to try to ask yourself, am I sitting straight? Am I sleeping straight? I mean, it really has to become part of your psyche. So it's very hard to make it a priority when you're not feeling pain, but I wanna let you know that physical therapists think it's the number one thing we should all be thinking about when we're trying to keep our bodies healthy. like regular fiddle practice or mandolin practice, guitar practice, banjo practice, you do things repetitively so that your muscles learn a kind of memory on their own. So you can actually create the same memory in your neck with these exercises that I'll be going through.
So I'll be posting videos to my Miss Moonshine posture playlist with daily exercises that you could do and good posture hacks that you could do to prioritize mobility in your life.